Hello and welcome to another lecture on vectors. Thus far we have studied about scalars and vectors, type of vectors, and today we shall be discussing about scalar product of vectors and their properties. Later we are going to deal up with direction cosines of a given vector, and finally we shall conclude this lecture based on vectors by discussing some numerical problems that would be based on evaluating the scalar product of a given vector and direction cosines of a given vector. So now starting with the scalar product of vectors, which is also known as the dot product. Now we know that since vectors have directions, these cannot be multiplied like numbers. Thus we are going to consider two non-zero vectors A and B, and are made to shift in such a position that they intersect at point O and make an angle of theta between them. Now the value of theta lies between 0 to pi, and the product of these two vectors, that is A and B, is represented as A dot B is equal to mod of vector A into mod of vector B cos theta, where theta already described as the angle formed between the two given vectors, that is A and B here, which is equal to AB cos theta, where A is equal to mod of vector A and B is equal to mod of vector B, and theta lies between the interval 0 to pi. Thus the product of two vectors, that is A and B, is equal to AB cos theta, and the product thus obtained is a scalar quantity. Now here we note that if A, that is vector A, is 0 and vector B is 0, then the product, that is the scalar product of the two given vectors, would be equal to 0. And if the value of theta is equal to pi by 2, that is 90, then also the value of this scalar product would be equal to 0, and the value of the scalar product of vectors is maximum when theta is equal to 0, and thus the scalar product is equal to AB. Next we are going to discuss the properties of a scalar or dot product. The first property of the scalar product is that it is commutative. That is, the scalar product of A vector and B vector is equal to the product of B and A. The second property is that the scalar product is distributive. That is, vector A into the addition of two vectors B and C is equal to the product of A and B plus the product of A and C. The third property is that M into vector A, and this product being multiplied with vector B, is equal to M into dot product of vector A and vector B, which is equal to A being multiplied to the product of M and vector B, where A and B represent vectors and M represent any real number or a scalar quantity. Another property gives us the value of the product of a vector A and a vector B with a negative sign, which is equal to minus of scalar product of two vectors, that is A and B. Similarly, when minus of vector A is being multiplied, or we obtain the scalar product of minus A vector and minus B vector, it is equal to the scalar product of A and B. Next, we have another property in which if two vectors, addition of two vectors, that is A and B, is equal to the subtraction of the same two vectors, this implies that A, vector A, is perpendicular to vector B. Next, we are going to consider the angle between two given vectors. For that, let us consider two vectors defined as vector A and vector B. Now, these two vectors have been joined to a point O and they form an angle theta, as we have discussed in the scalar product of two given vectors also. Now, the scalar product of these two vectors is equal to and is written as vector A into vector B is equal to vector A mod into vector B mod cos of theta, where theta represents the angle between these two given vectors. Now, this is equal to AB cos of theta. Thus, we can write cos theta equal to A dot B whole divided by mod of vector A and mod of vector B. Thus, we have cos theta equal to the scalar product of two given vectors divided by A, B, which implies that cos theta is equal to the dot product of two given vectors divided by product of their moduli. Next, we are going to discuss about the direction cosines of a given vector. Here, let AB be any vector in its space and OP be a vector passing through origin O and parallel to vector AB. Now, if vector OP makes angle alpha, beta and gamma with axis X, Y and Z, then alpha, beta and gamma are called as the direction angles of the vector AB, and cos of alpha, cos of beta and cos of gamma are known as the direction cosines of the vector AB. Now, if alpha, beta and gamma are the direction angles of a non-zero vector A, which is given as vector A equal to A1i plus A2j plus A3k, then its direction cosines are given as cos alpha, which is equal to vector A into I divided by mod of vector A and mod of unity vector I. This is equal to vector A into I divided by mod of vector A. Similarly, cos beta is equal to vector A into J divided by mod of vector A, and cos gamma is written as vector A into K divided by mod of vector A. That is, cos of alpha is equal to A1 by mod of A, cos of beta is equal to A2 by mod of A, and cos gamma is equal to A3 divided by mod of vector A. Or we can say that A1 is equal to mod A cos alpha. Similarly, A2 is equal to mod of vector A into cos beta, and A3 is equal to mod of A vector into cos gamma. Thus, it follows that the scalar components of A1, A2 and A3 of vector A are the projections of vector A along x-axis, y-axis and z-axis respectively. Next, we are going to discuss some numerical problems. Now, in this problem, we are required to evaluate the value of the angle between vectors 5i plus 3j plus 4k and 6i minus 8j and k. Now, in order to evaluate the value of theta, we need to evaluate the value of cos theta, which is equal to the product of these two vectors. Let's label them as vector A and vector B, divided by mod of vector A and vector B. Now here we have labeled this vector as vector A and this vector as vector B. Now in order to evaluate the cos theta, we need to evaluate the scalar product of these two vectors, which is equal to the dot product of A and B equal to 5i plus 3j plus 4k into 6i minus 8j minus k. Now this is equal to 5 into 6 plus 3 into minus 8 plus 4 into minus 1, which gives us a value of A dot B equal to 2. Next, we are going to evaluate the value of mod of vector A, which is equal to root of 5 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. This is equal to root of 50. Similarly, we can obtain the value of mod of B, which is equal to root of 6 square plus minus 8 square plus minus 1 square. Now mod B is equal to root of 101. Now substituting the values of A dot B and mod of A and mod of B in equation number 1, we have cos theta equal to 2 divided by root of 50 into root of 101. Now this can be rewritten as root of 2 divided by 5 root of 101. Thus we have the angle between these two given vectors as theta, which is equal to cos inverse of root 2 divided by 5 into root of 101. Thus we have evaluated the magnitude of angle between two given vectors. With this, we conclude this lecture on vectors, which was based on the scalar product of two given vectors.